Hey YouTube, Coppersan here. Today I'll be showing you how you can complete the Afterlands Team Dungeon in about an hour to get those juicy permanent totems. The Afterlands is a team dungeon that can be accessed starting from level 75. It gives decent EXP at that level and isn't too difficult to complete, but it can be completed at higher levels, let's say level 231 as well. We just defeated one of the Black Mage commanders, but this time this Balrog will be our undoing as we try to rescue this puppy. Our character dies and here we are in the Afterlands. There is a big door blocking the way back and it's up to us to find all 12 keys so we can leave this hellish place. After clearing the door and talking to our guiding spirit, Askshaya, he sends us away to our first destination, the Land of Warriors. Askshaya, by the way, is a wordplay on the Indian word Akshaya, which means infinite, everlasting and endless, and his spirit already made it very clear that it wants to keep us here forever. So after we brutally beat up all the contestants in the Greatest Warrior Ever contest that started at the Land of the Warriors, we regular attack the sun and make it night. We ask all the NPCs if they know about any keys, but only Edgar seems to know something about it. Move two maps to the right to defeat a junior Balrog that's holding a key. When completing this quest, the spirit will ask you to try it out right away, however I recommend holding on to it for later so you can use them all at once. We make a day again and I always start monster elimination, because I think that's the fastest. After beating those so-called warriors who have been doing this for an eternity again, the spirit asks us, hey, do you want to move on? We question ourselves if we want to, and the answer is yes, and the spirit moves us to the next area, the Land of Riches. We accept NPC's Joel quest and go hunt him some food. This food can be found in the first map with monsters in this area. I recommend getting 70 of those in one go, so you don't have to come back later. We talk to Joel again and complete his quest. He rewards us with some delicious gold and we accept the next quest right away. Finally, talk to Mansa before we're sent away again to the next area. Welcome to the Land of Contemplation. Those souls here lost their color, and after a brief cutscene we are tasked with finding anything that has some color in them. Move 3 maps to the right for the next phase of the quest to start, which has us hunt 50 ravens. But alas, we couldn't find anything that had any color, so the souls take matter into their own hands and steal our color. Whoa, rude. Next up we talk to Adler, who explains what exactly is going on here, and we get our very first key. Nice, only 11 more to go. And with that, we're done for here for now and go to the next area, the Land of Innocence. Here, we're going to bully some kids to get some more keys. Depending on the mood of the kids, the weather changes. We bully our first kid and collect frozen treats in the first map, and also make sure to collect an eye patch over here as well. By the way, if you are enjoying today's video so far, make sure to leave a like and subscribe for more MapleStory videos. Make sure to hit the bell notification as well so you never miss a video. We talk to Tina again to make even some more kids cry, making a thunderstorm happen this time. In the first map, we see now that lightning has struck a tree, and what do you know, a key was hiding in there all along, that's number 2. We collect 30 child toys in the third map in this area, and talk to Riley to finish the quest. Next up, we're talking to the artist NPC Billy, who's gonna help us get our color back that those NPCs from the previous area stole. Our goal is to defeat monsters and fill up the item that Billy gave you. When finished, he helps us get our color back. And this concludes the first part of this team dungeon. Let's get dangerous and get those other keys ASAP so we can leave this hellish place. The first thing that we're gonna do right away is attempted murder on Lonnie right here. She doesn't have a quest belt, but talk to her anyway. She mentions that she's afraid of heights, but after putting an eye patch on her, yeah, that one that we found earlier, she's now no longer afraid of the swing, and she has the third key that she gives to us. Next up is the Silent Boy. He's giving you the silent treatment, but we know how to break those kids' spirits, so just keep talking to him until he gives you your fourth key, and we can go back to the Land of Warriors. We arrive back in the Land of Warriors, and it looks like we murdered everyone in here as well by leaving the sun out. They just kept fighting until they couldn't anymore. Whoops! We make it night again, and a quest appears above your head. We fight some more monsters in the map to the right to complete the quest, except the quest from Vulcanally as well. We can't complete it yet, but we will soon. We just cleared the quest and made a day again, and tell the folks over here that today's mission is monster elimination again. Psych, we just killed all the monsters. I wonder how they'll react to our little prank. And as expected, they really liked it. So we make it night again and quickly move on to the next area. Talk to Joel again in the Land of Riches and start the quest The World Beyond the Castle Walls. He wants 10 more food baskets, which we already collected earlier. We complete the quest and start the next one, Excuses to Stay. Now he wants us to hunt down treasure thief monstrosities, which are just cute mice carrying treasures. But you know, we never say no to a good extermination of a totally innocent life form, so we hunt down 100 of them in the third map in this area. That finally convinces Joel to leave the castle walls, and we help him take his treasure out, and that's another quest complete. But still no keys though. We talk to Ben, who we also want to help. And next we talk to Mansa, but what do you know, we don't really feel like helping him yet, so we don't. We're gonna move on to the next area just to streamline things. No worries, we're coming back here soon, but this is probably the fastest way, trust me. In the land of contemplation, talk to Adler and share a color again with the other three NPCs here. Once that is done, talk to the Nameless Soul and go and defeat the Horde Death Beast for him. This just normal raven is in the final map of this area, and well, what do you know, it dropped a key. That's number 5. We return to the Nameless Soul and complete his quest. The next quest is a bit hidden. There is a chat box on the bench next to the Thinker statue. An NPC appears and we fall asleep, only to encounter the Yellow Mage, our arch nemesis. You can tell by his sophisticated attack pattern that this truly is the final boss of MapleStory. And after a good old one shot, he goes blasting off again and we save the day, and just like that we get our 6th key. Our next quest is in the Land of the Innocent, so make sure to go there. We talk to Tina and help her find her storybook that was taken by monsters. You should find it relatively easy in the first map of this area. After completing this one, we talk to her again, and now she wants a teddy bear. We talk to the shopkeeper NPC in the same map and buy an extremely expensive brand new teddy bear. Those totems ain't free, you know. Tina is very happy and she gives us her book. We double click it to open it with the Balrog key that we found in the Land of the Warriors at the start of the Afterlands, and that's key number 7. Then we accept the next quest from Tina, and she wants even more stuff. Boundaries, young lady. You know what? Those kids are way too happy, so we eat all their candy, make it rain, and move on to the next world. It'll teach them. We're back in the Land of Warriors, where everyone is sulking and dying again. We bring out the sun and start another day. You can pick any of the three options that you want. I just like monster elimination, honestly. The warriors are happy again, and we move on. Seriously, it took me a while to figure this one out, but click on the gold bag on the top right part of the map to start the next quest. Clicking on the bag will trigger a dialogue with Louis, and after we listen to his nagging, we talk to Horemheb. I honestly really don't want to deal with this drama, but we click on the light bulb above our head and then talk to Louis again, and that's enough for now. We walk to the far left side of the map and talk to the old tombstone maker. Defeat the rock at his right side and give it to him. Now, to complete this quest you have to wait 10 minutes, so in the meantime we're going to be working on getting the final keys. Talk to Joey to start his repeatable quest, where it will give you a gold piece in exchange for food or defeating monsters. Those quests are random, so don't go collecting food only because you think that might save you time, because it actually might end up costing you more time in doing so. After completing it 6 times though, we're finally gonna help Mansa escape the castle walls. Use the gold pieces to grow in size 3 times and regular attack the side of the building until the wall crumbles. Talk to Mansa after you're done destroying other people's property, and then he'll leave. Next up is Ben. I take Ben outside first because he's weak and frail, and then his treasure afterwards. And with that done, we skip through the worlds until we arrive in the Land of the Warriors again. We use the remaining 3 gold pieces to grow in size and talk to Vulcanelli to impress her with our size, and she will give us the 8th key. Our next step is clicking on the statue. This statue triggers a dialogue. Talk to Edgar next and go back to the statue. This spear can be thrown, it seems like, but only if it's wet. Well, guess what? We made it rain earlier by bullying those kids, so we can use the spear right away. Not sure where the rose came from though. Without wasting any time, we go back to the Land of the Riches to find out the bank has been destroyed, spilling out all the treasure. Talk to Horemheb next for some more drama, and he'll give you the 9th key. Next we talk to Mansa, who is outside and has purged all his gold contents, and inside it is the key. Yes, only 2 left. 10 minutes should have passed by now. Select which tombstone you want from this NPC. From what I know, this change is permanent, and I want a fancy golem tombstone when I die, so we get that one, and then we finally get the 11th key. Leave this map and come back in again. Talk to the tombstone maker NPC again and help him by dropping tombstones on souls. At this point I don't really question my actions anymore, I just wanna get out of here. We finish the quest and finally get all 12 keys. Talk to Askaya to return to the door map, and now we can spam click our way through all these locks and open the door. And just like that, we're back in the Maple World. There is the old man and we are alive and well again. We gain a box from this area that will reward 4 permanent totems. The totems from the Shanghai area have a bit better stats, but these totems right here are permanent and nice to fill out your totem slots with once your Shanghai totems expire. And that's how you can clear the Afterlands Steam Dungeon in about an hour. The rewards are those totems, a golden tombstone of any color that you've picked, and if you start the Steam Dungeon at a lower level, you probably got a few level ups along the way as well. I hope this video was useful for you, and that was all for today. As always, many thanks to our members for making this video possible. Thanks to Niels de Konnik, Rama Waar, Sebastian Hanoi, FLX, Jeff Wong, Pinky Traveler, Terry Kim, Juju, Galaxy Art, Gusus Rodriguez, Veriz, Ricer Ryu, Dries Sumker, Plux, Zenny, Wiley, Francisco Sousa, History Cannon, Backspace, OTI, CMAX, Saffronx, Lonzo, BG Extremes, Harry Gardner, Ido Hyman, Anwar NHI, Brandon, Frank Bouguet, Ziggy Deer, Fine Asian Guy, Mr. Potemkin, Flidiot, Beamer WT, Lars Smitch, Edgar, Knife Sue, Chen125, Cloudfix, Sir QQ Morse, and Gummy Bones. If you would like to be mentioned here as well and get early access to new videos, make sure to check out that join button below this video. Thank you so much for watching, stay safe, and happy mapling!